Hello friends, I welcome you on BYJU'S Exam Prep, India's most comprehensive preparation platform for all the engineers. Today I have with me one of the most respected faculty for GATE examination, GATE and Engineering Services examination, that is Faneen sir. And I welcome all the students in this session where we are going to talk about the opportunity in HPCL. We'll be talking about electrical and instrumentation. I will be taking care of the electrical part. And Faneen sir is going to take care of the instrumentation part. So all the candidates who are joining me live, just hit the like button, share it with your friends and colleagues. Just quickly tell me whether my audio, visual quality, everything is clear so that we can proceed with the session. HPCL, significant number of vacancies for electrical and instrumentation. Every single vacancy is going to be important for you because you don't know what your destiny has planned for you. So be ready for this opportunity. It is going to be a good opportunity. I welcome everyone. Hi, Madhuri. Please confirm whether my audio visual quality, everything is clear so that we can proceed. Once again, let me introduce with me, I have Faneen sir, one of the most renowned faculty for instrumentation. He is going to talk about the opportunity, the syllabus, the important topics and the procedure for HPCL vacancies for instrumentation. And I will be taking care of electrical engineering for HPCL vacancies. So friends, let's start with the session. Before we start, let me just give you a brief idea about myself, and then Faneen sir is going to tell something about himself, and then we are going to proceed. Some of you may be joining me for the first time, so there is a brief introduction about myself. My name is Ashutosh. As you can see on the screen, I have 11 plus years of teaching experience, completed M.Tech from IIT BHU 2010. I have written a couple of books on engineering ethics and power system, as you can see on the screen. I have my areas of expertise as one of the most important core subjects for electrical engineering, that is power system, electrical machines, electromagnetic field theory, material science, engineering ethics, and current affairs. Over to you, Faneen sir. Can you please introduce yourself and take up the session for IN?
Very good evening, Ashutosh sir, and a very good evening to all of my dear students. I heartily welcome everyone onto the platform. This is a wonderful evening. Today we are going to discuss about the HPCL exam because many students, they're asking repetitively, regularly in WhatsApp and Telegram groups, sir, please take some session on HPCL. So we have discussed it together and we plan to take a HPCL strategy along with the live, as well as along with the syllabus, along with the previous year questions, one and all. So before getting into the actual topics of the session, first, let me quickly introduce about myself. So the students who are regular to my classes, they might be so familiar about me. But for the new students, let me quickly introduce myself. As you all can see on the slide, all put together, I have 11 plus years of teaching experience and I have graduated from NIT Tiruchi. After that, I have been continuously teaching all over the country. And up to now, I have taught more than 50,000 students in the subjects of control system and industrial instrumentation and circuit theory and many more subjects related to electrical and ECE and instrumentation things. And as I said, like I'm quite known for industrial instrumentation. And in this evening, we are going to discuss what is the actual requirement of HPCL and how we planned the course of HPCL that will give the maximum benefit to every one of you. The only thing what you must have is you should have the patience till the end and be with us. And I'm very sure that this is a valuable session to every one of you. But moving forward, I would like to tell about this program. Rakesh Tareja sir, one of the famous faculty in BEP and one of the most lovable faculty, isn't it? So every Sunday, he is onto the platform and he's taking some of the very beautiful concepts from the aptitude and he teach in more funny ways. So you have to attend the class and enjoy the sessions too much. And every weekend, don't forget this and enjoy weekend with the technical concepts along with the aptitude also. Okay. So moving forward to very important thing that as you know that most of the students, they're continuously asking me the day when the HPCL notification is out, I have seen a lot of messages in Telegram group as well as WhatsApp, even on the Facebook also. So you can come to my Telegram group where I have all these things, exam notifications, not only exam notification of HPCL, even BARC, any kind of examination. Once it is, its notification is done. So we will going to have a detailed explanation about the notification. Followed to that, we will going to have the PDF and notes, whatever is related to that particular examination. And for HPCL, you can find every resource and every material start from day after tomorrow onwards in the Telegram group. And more important thing is, we will going to give the session updates in the Telegram group, as well as just below this video, you will find the comment box, and in the comment box, you can see the upcoming schedule along with the Telegram channel also link. So, and most importantly, daily important questions, and along with that, we'll also take some doubt clarification, because I personally believe that most of you, means the students who are going to appear for HPCL examination, you have already cleared the gate, or you might have attended the gate, right? But many of you might not score very good rank in the GATE examination. So it is a great opportunity to you, because the syllabus coverage is similar to the GATE examination, but the depth in the exam is slightly less. In fact, it is very less. You will understand that in one or two slides later. So how to study, how much to study, when to study, where to study, what is the material, and what are the mock tests, all these updates will be given in the Telegram group. So that's why I sincerely request every one of you, whoever are serious to the examination, whoever want to get placement in the HPCL, please follow the session updates so rigorously. And more importantly, what are the essential ingredients you must require? So many of you might have gone through some news, and most of you might have here and there that HPCL has given the notification. I am very sure that most of you might not have gone through the complete notification also. Isn't it? So the very first thing what you must do is go through the notification details and clearly read from top to bottom. Have patience. You all have studied 10 to 11 subjects for GATE examination, isn't it? So notification is a very small thing, right? It's just a matter of 4 to 5 slides or 4 to 5 pages. Go through the entire notification so that you will really understand what are the demands of the HPCL and what is the syllabus, what you need to do, what you should not do, all these things, right? So there are some students who started asking the questions, right? So, but you must understand this one important thing. We are coming onto the platform and we are delivering the lecture series on HPCL for free of cost, okay? Because, you know, first of all, Byju's is student friendly, and second important thing is most of the students are regularly asking. So that's the reason why we decided to take the free classes on YouTube, and that will give maximum benefit to the majority of the students. And once the notification is thoroughly, rigorously completed, then immediately you should go and see what is the selection procedure. I'll tell you a very simple story. Not so many things. Selection procedure is different for different PSUs. BIRC has a different structure and different selection procedure. Followed to that, HPCL has a different selection procedure, and maybe ONGC might be having the selection procedure. Sometimes in the selection procedure, you will have some unimaginable things. Like HPCL has one of the stages which is called as a group task, and majority of you might even not know about the group task. That group task may be a general discussion, that may be GD, or that maybe they may give a topic and they may ask in front of everyone, or they may give some kind of teamwork and they will analyze how you are working as a team member. So this is very interesting, isn't it? So that's why you must go through the selection procedure and see what are the requirements of the HPCL from the selection procedure, and start increasing the abilities of you in according to the requirement of the HPCL. And most importantly, I would like to tell this thing, that is syllabus. So I have been even receiving now also so many messages that what is the syllabus of HPCL? Trust me, HPCL have not, it doesn't mention any syllabus usually, but it is expected that more or less the GATE syllabus will be the syllabus of any PSU examination, because ultimately GATE is considered as a reference for the every technical examination. If the examination syllabus is mentioned in upcoming days in HPCL website, that is great, very great. Even if it is mentioned, definitely it will going to include the GATE syllabus. So you can, by default, you can take GATE syllabus as a reference and start building your own capabilities only with respect to the GATE syllabus. That will be very, very important. And now most important thing is important topics and level of examination. I would like to tell this very, very important topic, because GATE is a very vast syllabus, right? So in fact, in each and every subject, we have so many topics to cover. Sometimes the topics may be so much important. Sometimes the topics might not be so important. But when it comes to PSUs, trust me, you need not to cover every topic. But which topic you should cover, that we will go into explain in each and every session, starting from the Wednesday onwards. Okay. And more importantly, level of examination. As I was repeatedly saying to everyone, the level of HPCL examination is very less compared to the GATE examination. We will also show you some of the previous year questions in this particular PPT so that you will believe our words and you yourself can understand what is the level of the examination. And I'm very sure at the end of this presentation, you will come to a conclusion that the HPCL exam is very, very, very less standard compared to the GATE examination. But you have to go a little bit different way compared to your GATE examination. That's why stay tuned to the channel and listen each and every lecture till the end. Well, so coming to the most important thing, the practice material. As I was saying, in Telegram group, as well as those students who are so interested, if you raise the request, we will be supporting with the practice material of the HPCL. Not only the practice material of the HPCL, we will also conduct the exams based on your demand. If more and more students are interested, see, only I'm seeing 33, the count has to go to at least 60 to 70. Once it reaches to the high demand, naturally we are forced to create the material as well as the test series of HPCL also. So everything depends on your interest. Now the ball is in your court and it is you should hit out of the ground. Okay, so coming to the very, very important topic, that is notification details. Most importantly, for electrical engineering, you can see almost 42 vacancies are there. Of course, the maximum age limit is 25. I am speaking with respect to general category, because general category will be taken as a reference. So I can't explain like for general this is, OBC this and all this. That's why you should go to the notification. So with respect to general category, the age is going to be 25 and the maximum vacancies are 42. So obviously 42 is quite a good number, isn't it? Electrical students must answer this. Sir, when we can expect the syllabus, sir? So Nirvesh Kumar, as of now, in the website, it was mentioned that they will going to announce the syllabus soon. But trust me, if you wait till the syllabus to announce, of course, the time will be wasted. So you consider the GATE syllabus as a reference and start your preparation. Suppose if the HPCL announced the syllabus is falling in the GATE syllabus, then it is very good for you. Suppose in case HPCL syllabus is just above the GATE syllabus, by the time you have completed the GATE syllabus, then you can prepare that extra portion. But don't delay your preparation as the syllabus is not given. Okay, that is very, very, it's not a good idea. And Madhuri, yes, sir, please share the practice material for HPCL. Sure, we will try to help in all the way. That's why we are conducting the live session, isn't it? So the only thing is you need to follow the sessions continuously, rigorously, each and every time when we announce the session. And most important, essential requirement is 4 years of full-time degree you must possess in the same department. If you want to get into electrical department, you must have 4 years of electrical degree. And this is very quite common things, right? So even with the common sense, you can understand this. And more importantly, for instrumentation engineers. So for instrumentation engineers, usually you will not find so many vacancies. And even I was surprised a little bit when I have seen this number, like 30 vacancies. 30 in instrumentation is quite a good number. And more notifications are about to come. And I'm very sure every notification will help you so much. And going forward, even in instrumentation department, the maximum age limit is 25 years and you must possess 4 years full-time degree from the instrumentation. Of course, there are some other departments which are connected to the instrumentation. Those people are also eligible. Now let me give a clear picture. For electrical people, you must have the educational background either from electrical or electrical and electronics. Clear? So that means a double E or else only from ECE students also. They can write, I guess, if they want to do, but unfortunately they can't answer the questions like power systems and power electronics as well as machines, isn't it? So it's better to have this essential qualification. And coming to instrumentation, so either a student who is passed out from instrumentation or who is graduating from instrumentation or instrumentation and control, or else electronics and instrumentation, or instrumentation and electronics. Now you see, whatever the way it is rounding here and there, Finally, you must possess your degree in instrumentation. Then you are eligible to write the HPCL exam. Okay. So give me 1 minute time. Let me see your comments and understand what is your demand. Sir, what may be the expected date for the exam? See, Santosh, so this is what I'm saying. You don't try to go and expect about the syllabus or don't think about the date. You start your preparation. Let the date announce later also. No problem, right? So you should be ready with everything. Right now, we cannot ask the HPCL management, please announce the date. Of course, it is them. They will going to decide and announce the date. But the only thing what is there in our hand, let us put our effort to utilize that what is there in our hand. So in our hand, the only thing which is available with us is prepare well, right? So let's put our efforts to prepare well rather than thinking about the syllabus and gate exam, I mean like date and all these things, okay? Right? So anyway, Ashutosh sir has given the idea. So it is expected to be in mid of September. So now we have a very good time, July and even August and even half of the September month. So it's a good time and it's a golden opportunity also, right? So moving forward to this, right? So usually for the technical jobs, right? Like if you want to be a management trainee or as the HPCL officer, very important qualification is 60% of the marks you should get in your graduation. This most of the students, they don't go through this point. But I feel that most of the students have minimum of 60%, right? So if you are not having 60%, I'm very sorry that you are not eligible to write the HPCL exam. And moving forward, that is selection procedure. So I think I have spoken a lot many things so far, right? So one thing I would like to say, it's a good opportunity for both electrical people and instrumentation people, especially the students who have not done so extensively well in gate examination. So Ashutosh sir will going to explain the selection procedure, and follow to that, he will also show you what are the different stages of the selection procedure, and he will also explain what is the syllabus of the examination along with the previous year questions, so that you will really understand what is the standard of the exam, which is very, very important before going to write the exam. Over to you, Ashutosh sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for the opportunity. And guys, there is a great information coming from one of the most reputed GATE faculty, that is Faneen sir. So let us understand, guys, what is the selection procedure. But before that, I want all of you to just tell me in the comment section, how many of you are very, very serious for HPCL recruitment? I just want a heart sign or thumbs up symbol, and I want to know that how many you are very serious for HPCL recruitment. Because let me tell you, any company which is related to the oil sector, it is going to be a very, very big opportunity for your career, because there are a lot of perks apart from the salary that you are getting. The growth is very good, the job nature is very good, and the postings or the other promotions, perks, all these things are going to be very good when it comes to the oil sector. So all the candidates who are live with me, just tell me once in the comment section whether you are ready for this big opportunity or not, and then I'm going to tell you what is the selection procedure. Now let's understand the selection procedure. I can divide this whole examination into three parts. The first part is going to be the written examination, like any other examination. The second part is going to be the group task. This group task, in the most simple words you can understand, it is a kind of group discussion like any other interview procedure. The third stage is going to be the interview part. So we have basically three stages: written test, group discussion, and then interview. Let us come to the first part, that is the written test part. This written test part is divided into two parts. The first one is, part one is general aptitude. This general aptitude consists of basically three sections, that is English language, quantitative aptitude, and intellectual potential test. Let me tell you, this is not any alien word I'm using here. It is given in the HPCL notification itself, but you please understand, it is nothing but your logical reasoning, logical ability, nothing more, nothing less. I will tell you some specific details also, and I will tell you how you can prepare well for this recruitment, because I have years and years of experience that how these exams are going to trick you and how they are going to trouble you, and how in the most efficient way you can at least secure one seat for yourself. So let us understand part two. Part two is going to be your technical domain, your technical part. For electrical engineers, it is going to be electrical engineering, and it is going to be common for electrical and you can say triple E also. Okay, triple E also. And for instrumentation, it is going to be instrumentation. There are some other branch, similar streams that Fanin sir has already told you, that is, it is instrumentation and electronics, electronics and instrumentation. So you can see the specific details in the notification, but more or less for instrumentation, it is for instrumentation, for electrical, it is electrical. Now you see, one of the most interesting part of this examination is that there is no negative marking. There is no negative marking, whether it is part one or part two. But let me tell you, there is going to be section cutoff. There is going to be section cutoff in order to finally go through with this technical written test, technical or the non-technical part written test. And this sectional cutoff, after this sectional cutoff, one most important hurdle that you have to answer is the number of questions. Fanin sir has rightly said that if you see the level of examination, GATE is going to be much superior. If you, I will show you the level of questions that are being asked in the previous years. But if you see the number of questions that you have to solve in 150 minutes, in 150 minutes, you have to solve 170 questions. So the difficulty level has been reduced, but at the same time, the number of questions has been increased and there is going to be sectional cutoff. It means this exam is all about time management. And there is no problem for accuracy, but you have to be accurate because you have to maximize your score. There is no negative marking. So you don't need to worry much about the accuracy. Definitely there should be accuracy because you have prepared well. But at the same time, you must have a very well-prepared time management, a well-planned, you have to go in the examination hall. Then only you can succeed in this particular examination. Let me go through the next. That is a syllabus. Now let us understand the syllabus for aptitude. As I told you, it is written in the previous slide. In the previous slide, it is written as intellectual potential test. You please understand, it is nothing but your simple aptitude and logical reasoning. So if you see the syllabus for aptitude, it is going to be very common. A lot of sessions you have already attended in the BYJU'S Exam Prep YouTube channel. That is number system, pipes and systems, partnership, simple and compound interest, permutation and combination, simplification, time and distance, average, mensuration. And one thing, once I cover up with this particular slide, I want to ask all of you, do you believe that this all aptitude you can revise in one day? Can you promise this to yourself? Can you promise this to yourself? And if you are not able to believe this, let me tell you that definitely we'll come up with a session in which the concerned faculty is going to take care of all these important topics in one session only. So please wait for that session and stay connected to BYJU'S Exam Prep and subscribe to BYJU'S Exam Prep if you have not subscribed till now. More, if you see the intellectual potential, there is nothing but the logical ability part. It has puzzle test, coding and decoding, number series. These are very common aptitude and logical reasoning areas that you must have seen already. Then we have seating arrangement, logical sequence test, arithmetic operation, direction sense test, blood relation, and data sufficiency. So all these topics you must be familiar. Yes, definitely. Rakesh sir will help you in that regard. Let me just talk about the remaining syllabus for intellectual potential. That is logical Venn diagram, number and ranking, time sequence, sequential output test, syllogism, direction sense, I have already covered, arithmetic operation, analogy, alphanumerical sequence puzzle. Some of the question I'm just showing you to show you what is going to be the level of questions, because you don't need to worry because this much syllabus is given. So you are going to be a little bit nervous at how we are going to cover all these things. But these are very, very small things. I can tell you approximately 60 to 70% of the syllabus of this aptitude part and the intellectual potential part, that is logical reasoning or logical ability, you have already mastered. You have already mastered with BYJU'S Exam Prep. The remaining 20, 30% you have to little excel yourself, and that is required. Just see the level of questions. Choose a sentence which is grammatically correct. Bring me that hot of pot soup. So you can see these are very common sense. If you just have common sense, you can solve these questions. You don't need any extra bit of effort. Okay, so don't worry about that. Where you have to focus? You have to focus on 30 to 40% of the aptitude and logical reasoning part in the remaining period till mid-September when the exam is going to be conducted. And at the same time, you should be very strong with your technical part. Because let me tell you, technical part is going to be very time consuming because the number of questions are going to be very high in comparison to the time you are having for the examination. See the next question. Choose the most appropriate option to complete the sentence. You must always have faith. Now, you know that faith in your parents, at, about, and inside is going to be incorrect. So if you have a little bit of command on your verbal ability part, then it is going to be an easy section for you. Then you can have some aptitude questions, very regular conventional questions you are getting in these type of examinations, and it's all about speed and accuracy. But there is no negative marking, but still you have to be accurate because you want to build a good score. See, number system, they are asking questions, then they are asking some profit and loss type of questions. So these questions you must have already prepared well. That is what I'm expecting out of you. You see, simple mathematical operations. Average of four smallest prime numbers. So you must have prepared. If not, then you can prepare with Baiju's exam prep. And 20 to 30% of syllabus of aptitude and logical reasoning that you are not comfortable or familiar, definitely the concerned faculty or Rakesh or whatever faculty is going to be available, he's going to take care of that part. So don't worry about it. There are some more logical reasoning, that is intellectual potential part. Now see, it is a blood relation question. It is going to be what we call as these type of questions. It is slipping from my mind for the time. So these type of questions, some special aptitude, I think it comes under a special aptitude, this or this, it comes under the special aptitude. So you must have seen these type of questions. Just little bit efforts you are going to make, just brush up the basic concepts, stay connected to Baiju's exam prep. We are coming with every nook and corner of the requirement for this examination, and this is going to be a big opportunity of recruitment for you. Let me talk about the syllabus for electrical and instrumentation. Let me tell you that Funin sir is going to take care of the common portion of electrical and instrumentation because he's the genius for the subjects he is taking in instrumentation, electronics, and electrical. I will be dealing with the core subjects for electrical. So let me just brief you some few points about the electrical. Then Funin sir is going to take care of the common subjects, that is his subjects for electrical and instrumentation. Let me just talk about power system. You please understand the requirement of this examination. This examination is not going to give you questions where there is going to be lengthy calculations. 40%, 35 to 40% of the questions that you are going to face in this examination, as far as technical part is concerned, they are going to be direct, conceptual, theoretical questions. If you know the concept, if you know the trick, very easily you can do it. Second type of questions you will be getting where there is a little bit of effort is required. So if you are comfortable with that particular question, you can do it. Third category, there will be some questions, approximately 5 to 8% of the questions that are going to be very time consuming because this examination is all about time management. So what you have to do, those 5 to 8% of the questions, what you have to say, all is well, all is well, all is well. It means you don't need to let your emotions dominate you. Just wait for the right time, wait for the right question, and then you hit it, hit the nail. So those 5 to 8% of the questions where they are very time consuming, you have to avoid them. You have to keep them for the later part of your examination duration. But first you have to hit those questions which are direct, easy to go through, and then little bit of effort and you can get the answer. That type of questions you have to attack. Power system, machines. Let me give you some small points. For example, power system. You must be comfortable with the basics of transmission line. How you are calculating the GMD part, GMR part. You must be comfortable with different type of conductors. You must be comfortable with, the calculation of inductance and calculation. You must be comfortable with the star and delta connection. And you must be comfortable with the real and reactive power. These fundamental concepts. And very easily you can revise them because you have sufficient time. The examination is going to be held in mid of September. You can talk about the Y-bus. You can talk about the steady state and transient stability. Small concept, small formula, small answers. You can talk about the steady state stability limit. You can talk about the transient stability. You can talk about the, coherent systems. You can talk about the non-coherent systems when it comes to the parallel operation. You can talk about the fault analysis. You can talk about the relay. Relay is going to be very important. Circuit breaker is going to be very important. For example, differential relay, you can get direct questions. Distance relays, whether it is impedance relay, reactance relay, or more relay, you can get direct questions. Let me just talk about some of the area like economic load dispatch. You can also expect some questions. Okay. So these type of the areas are going to be important for power system. Let me just talk about machines. If you talk about electrical machines, see, electrical machine is going to be a very vast subject. So I would suggest you, if you have already covered this subject, then you just need a revision. If you have not covered this subject properly, then do not worry. Do not just haste in such a way that you mess up everything. Whatever you read for electrical machines, what suppose you focus on DC machine and induction. These are the most simple parts of your electrical machines. DC machine, induction and transformer. For the time being, just leave synchronous. If you are a little bit worried about synchronous, at least DC machine, induction and transformer you can cover. You will be getting very simple questions. Transformers, you will be getting simple voltage regulation questions. You will be getting simple efficiency questions. You will be getting condition for maximum efficiency. You see, for a transformer, three-phase transformers, you will be getting parallel operation of transformer questions. Some constructional details can also be asked. Okay. Similarly, if you talk about induction motor, you should have all the equations with you. Torque formula, slip formula, what is slip frequency? Are you getting this? All these basic things you must have. Starting of three-phase induction motor, star delta, auto transformer, direct online starter, reduced voltage starting, all these things must be on your tips. That is minimum required to get a reputed job. This is going to be a big opportunity for all the electrical engineers and IN. Similarly, if you talk about DC machines, now DC machines, the application part is also going to be very important. What are the application issues in DC series? Why DC series motor cannot be used on no load? What are the application issues with DC shunt motor and DC generator or DC machines overall? What is commutation? What is armature reaction? All these issues, you must have command over these areas. But my suggestion is, for machines at least, whatever you read it in the most perfect manner. That is going to help you to build your subject, because this is a very vast subject. Coming back to the next part, that is power electronics. See, power electronics, you are not going to expect much, you can say, time consuming questions. Most of the questions are going to be direct. They are going to be based on some basic concepts of the trick. So if you're comfortable, you can go with it. For example, there will be most of the time theoretical questions. There will be most of the time questions which are directly based on the formula. Are you getting this? So rectifiers and choppers and voltage regulators, all these important areas, you must revise with all the important formulas. And definitely Faneen sir and I are going to tell you that how Baijus exam prep is going to help you in that. We have planned every single session in such a way that if you stay connected to us, it is completely free of cost available. And I will be telling you, we'll be telling you the exact schedule for these classes also. So over to you, Faneen sir, please tell our students that how they have to prepare for electrical and instrumentation as far as your core subjects are concerned. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ashutosh sir. That's a wonderful explanation. I really loved it when you shown the aptitude questions. In fact, I felt like, you know, the data interpretation questions as well as blood relation questions, those questions are looking like the campus placement questions. In fact, they are not even the gate standard also. Those require these type of questions. They require very common sense. In fact, I don't say that you require so much of a great, you know, like research oriented topics. Those are very, very simple topics. I think everybody can easily answer that if they have minimum common sense aptitude part. And more importantly, many students are asking one simple question, that what is the standard of the examination? So let me tell you one simple fact here. All put together, we have 170 questions, right? So 170 questions and 180 minutes is the time, right? So now you tell me, even if you are an examiner or if you are going to conduct the exam of 170 questions in 180 minutes, do you keep so much depth questions or else so much conceptual questions? Of course not, right? So a student must be able to answer the question in 1 minute maximum. So obviously the standard of the questions will be less, but however, you cannot neglect it. The reason is, if it is a difficult exam, I repeat, if it is a difficult exam, then those students who have prepared so accurately, so genuinely, so seriously, so sincerely, they will be able to ace the exam. But if the exam is easy, then you should be much more well prepared. Because even if you have done mistake in one single question, that will cost so much. So this is the reason why there are many students who will be able to score more than 150 questions. So you should plan according to that and don't try to do research in any subject right now. Just revise your, you know, or short notebook, whatever you have prepared for the GATE examination, or else once you connected to the channel, then we will provide the material and we will provide the mock examinations and we will provide the sessions to you. So if you follow that, we will try to cover every session. In every session, we will try to cover the syllabus in more genuine way towards to the HPCL examination. And even the HPCL sessions, which we are offering for free of cost, they will not be to the level of the GATE standard. They will be completely to the HPCL standard, so that the college going students, as well as the students who have not appeared for the GATE examination, as well as not cleared the GATE examination, or else the, the people who are working in any other PSUs, they can all follow our free lectures on the YouTube. So this is the help what we can do. And I sincerely feel that that is more than required. As Ashutosh sir said this point very well and articulated very well, that it is one of the big opportunity for every one of you. And remember this point, 170 questions, 180 minutes, and more importantly, out of this 170 questions, 85 questions are like, you know, aptitude as well as general questions and, you know, data interpretation. They will give some kind of a different four figures and they will ask you to find out the odd man out. So these kind of questions are so popular. You might have done so many questions in your campus placements, isn't it? And difference comes here is that the remaining 85 technical questions. So these technical 85 questions will try to cover the whole syllabus of the GATE examination, and that is where you require to put your extra effort once again. Okay, so now let me tell you the common syllabus, because as Ashutosh sir requested me to go for the common syllabus, let me start with the circuit theory. As you all know, electrical students as well as instrumentation students, right, as you all know this point very well, that so circuit theory is going to be the basic subject, isn't it? Right. So yeah, yes, even if it is 150 minutes, then, you know, then 170 questions in 150 minutes, you have to be too fast. So the standard of the exam will be less. Right. So coming to the circuit theory, what I would like to say is I have seen even the previous year examination, even previous year papers. It is very, very simple, very, very simple. Even with a simple mesh analysis, nodal analysis, you will be able to solve the questions. And there are some questions which were asked in such a way that you need not to put your pen on the paper. Just by looking at the question itself, you will be able to answer it if you have at least a simple basics. Okay. And same thing even in the signals in systems and control system. And especially in control systems, I have seen that. So most importantly in control system, there were some questions in second order system dynamics. What is the zeta value or what is the DC gain and all these things. Okay. So this is very, very important to understand. And going ahead, the analog electronics part, and analog electronics part, very simple way, they will give an operational amplifier circuit and ask what is the gain of this, or else they may ask that a simple question like showing the filter transfer function and ask what kind of filter that is. But remember that you will not be allowed to do so many calculations in the examination. The reason is the depth of the questions is not so much. Okay. So I'm moving ahead with the next one, that digital electronics, and I will show you some of the questions on the digital electronics so you will understand the standard. Okay. And measurements, and coming to industrial instrumentation, because the measurement subject is common to both electrical guys as well as instrumentation guys. So I have seen the previous year questions, the questions on PMMC basics, like they are asking the whether which of the following instrument is capable to measure only DC input signal. Probably that is the basic question and the first topic you will be studying in measurements, isn't it? So that is the level of the question. And I have seen one more question that they have given some kind of waveform, right? And they asked that what would be the value indicated by the moving iron instrument. So that is the true RMS, right? So these are the level. In fact, these are the different types of questions. When it comes to industrial instrumentation, I have seen 3-4 questions. The very first question is, they have given like the gauge factor, they have given what is the initial resistance of the strain gauge, and they asked the question like what would be the final value of the resistance if there is a small amount of the strain. So if you look at the gauge standard, the one mark level questions are the questions of this examination. This is the reason why I'm saying that if you put little bit effort, that is more than sufficient. And moving forward to the next one, that is optical instrumentation. Optical instrumentation is also so important for instrumentation students. and there were many questions in HPCL previous year papers from optical instrumentation subject. And in optical instrumentation, you need not to study about the interference concepts, as well as you need not to study about, you know, optical pyrometer and all this. Most important concepts in optical instrumentation are, first is detectors and optical fiber, light detectors and optical fiber and light sources. So these are the three topics that are sufficient and you will be able to score full. Okay. And in industrial instrumentation, especially, as I said, LVDT concepts like inductive sensors and piezoelectric sensors and, you know, capacitive sensors and resistive sensors. And you need not to go so deeply into the humidity measurement, viscosity measurement and angular velocity measurement, acceleration measurement. No, not all this. Very popular type of sensors like orifice meter, venturimeter. If you take these topics, which are so famous in instrumentation engineering, and those are sufficient. You have to practice the numericals of one mark level, and that is more sufficient. Okay. Now moving ahead to the next subject, that is process control instrumentation. Okay. So the process control instrumentation, I have seen 2-3 questions on the controller part and control valve part. So the controllers as well as control valves, I have already took almost 6-7 sessions in the YouTube itself. Those students who want this, please go to the playlist and click instrumentation. You will be able to see the lectures on the process control, followed by that, you know, controllers, as well as followed by that, you can also see the lectures on control valves. So those lectures, which are available in BYJUS exam prep studio, as well as the, you know, playlist, those are more sufficient. In fact, those are far beyond than the requirement. Okay. And I hope I have covered all the common subjects as well as the core instrumentation part. Anyway, Ashutosh sir has given a wonderful idea about the electrical exam. Now, let me show you some of the questions so that you will understand the level of the question. Because I'm very sure that even 100 times, if I say that the exam is going to be easy, exam is going to be easy, many of the students, they don't believe it. So now you can see here, the closed loop transfer function of a negative feedback system is a 10. Okay, so they themselves have given that, and the feedback factor is 0.05. Once again, yes, what will be the open loop gain? So can we expect the easier question than this, right? So simply we can say the transfer function of the closed loop system is Z divided by 1 plus G into H, and they have given T is equal to 10, of course, right? And they are saying that the feedback factor is 0.05, right? And they're asking what is the value of G. Probably these kind of questions are very, very easy, isn't it? Even for the university level, you will not be asked these kind of questions, correct? So, and now you can see a DC circuit is Thevenized and found to have parameters as a 25 ohm and 10 volt. What will be the maximum power that is transferred to the load? So you know that in Thevenized circuit, or else any circuit which is converted into the Thevenin model will have one voltage source and resistor. This is the definition of the Thevenin theorem. And just additional to that, we have connected the load and we were asked to find out the maximum power. And there is a direct mathematical formula for the maximum power transfer, correct? So easily you will be getting, not even it will take 1 minute time. This is what I'm saying. It is very easy to clear this examination if you have a little bit basics also. Okay. Moving ahead to the next level of questions, like, see this, if you look at my notes, or if you refer the material of BYJUS exam prep, you will understand that this same line is there in the material also, right? In fact, you can see that we have collected the snapshot from the material itself. Even the watermark is also visible here, right? So you can easily understand that how valuable each and every basic lines it was mentioned in the material as well as in the questions also. Like in CRT based CRO, which horizontal voltage moves the luminous part from left to right in a periodic manner. In fact, I have taken almost around 45 minutes to 1 hour to explain this concept in the regular session of the measurement. And the answer for this is the internally generated ramp voltage, right? So those who have attended, this is a cakewalk. Those who have not attended the sessions previously, at least try to attend the sessions from the Wednesday onwards, because from Wednesday onwards, we are clearly planning the schedule such that it will cover the maximum amount of the students and benefit maximum amount of the students. So those who have not been the part of our earlier discussion and regular classes, at least try to utilize the opportunity now and explore the concepts. And going to the next one, that is 42 question in the paper, previous year paper, you can see If the function f of x comma y comma z is equal to this, probably if Rakesh sir is there, he could have been explained this very well compared to me, because this is digital electronic question, right? But I know that personally, this is a very easy question. In GATE, it will be considered as one mark question, right? So these questions seems to be easy, but the only thing what you require is accuracy. Here, more the speed is very important, and even the accuracy is also very important. In GATE, it is a balance that is required, but here both should be maximum. The reason is, even if you miss one simple question to answer in a wrong way, or if you answer wrongly one simple question, that will make you different from the other people. Okay, so moving ahead to the next one, like, yeah, some of the questions from the instrumentation technical, right? These are the previous year questions, and I'm very sure that the students who have attended my classes, these questions are nothing even, right? So compute the gauge factor if the change in resistance is 0.2 ohm and change in length is 0.6%, right? Probably that is the easiest question, right? And even next question, you see, flow can be measured by dash. You don't require to take 10 seconds time for this, right? So easily by looking at this, you will be able to answer that answer as a anemometer. Clear? That's why again and again, I am saying that out of 170 questions, 85 technical questions, almost out of 85, 40 to 50 questions, you will be able to answer by looking at the question. Only the remaining questions, you have to put a little bit effort. Okay. Now moving ahead to the comparison. Most important slide this is, because I'm seeing some of the students are electrical and some students are instrumentation. So the number of vacancies are 42 for electrical and 30 for instrumentation. And even you can see the number of questions are 170. Okay, that's what I told you earlier. And if you look at the cutoff, as of now, it is highly impractical to say what is the cutoff, but I'm very sure that the cutoff will be so high. Why? Because the exam is easy, right? Simple. And the last date for the application is 22/7/22. What a good number this is, right? Right. So these are, comparison details. In fact, you can see mechanical has a very, very huge number of vacancies. Okay. Moving ahead, study and practice material. I think Ashutosh sir is the correct person to explain this. Let me hand over to the Ashutosh sir and try to enjoy his session also. Sir, please. Try to go with this, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for the opportunity. It was a great information coming from a legendary faculty, Faneen sir, by himself. So friends, I see the number of people in the session live, they are decreasing. I don't know why, because when Faneen sir was telling you all these minor small details, at least I was getting goosebumps. I don't know whether you are getting the same feeling or not, because the blood is really running in my veins for this examination. Please understand, it is a big opportunity. Any job which is related to oil sector is going to be a big opportunity for you, whether it is growth, whether it is promotion, whether it is perks, whether it is incentives, whether it is salary, whatever you can dream of a good job, you all those things you are going to get in the oil sector jobs. Whether it is the posting, whether it is the work nature, job nature, you are going to be 100% satisfied with this particular job. Anyways, let us move on to the next part of our discussion, that is the study and practice material. See, one simple thing I'm going to tell you, that Baiju's exam prep has meticulously planned a series of sessions for HPCL recruitment. Today we are talking about electrical and instrumentation. I will be showing you the exact schedule, and you can follow that schedule. All these classes are going to be free of cost. We'll be coming up with the theory portion also. We'll be coming up with the practice problems also, and we'll be telling you how you should approach a particular subjects, and we'll be focusing on important areas also. The only thing you have to do is stay connected to Baiju's exam prep. If you have not subscribed, subscribe it right now, share it with your friends and colleagues so that more and more people are going to be benefited. So Baiju's exam prep is going to be one important part of your resource for HPCL recruitment. That is first thing. But how you are going to approach it? The first thing for any examination, the first step is that you at least see the previous year question paper. Suppose you are going for HPCL recruitment, so you are not aware how the questions are going to be. I am Faneen sir, we are trying our best to tell you, but still, until and unless you take the very printout, hard copy, not the soft copy, scrolling your mobile, no, this is not required. Take the hard copy, spend at least 100, 200 bucks from your pocket. Take the hard copy and try to solve those previous year questions. That is at least what you have to do. Every single recruitment that you are going for, every single job that you are going for. Second thing is previous year questions of GATE. of 1 mark. Because of the level of the questions that are being asked in this examination, we have seen, we have experienced that most of the time, various PSUs, they are going to follow the tradition, the custom, the level, the convention set by GATE and Engineering Services. So at the max, what you can do, at least 1 mark questions for some of the previous year, you can try for from GATE. And that is going to be a big resource, big confidence booster for you for this examination. Then comes previous year Engineering Services, ISRO and DRDO questions. See what happens. Let me tell you the exact situation. The situation is, whatever PSU is going to conduct any examination, what they do, they basically outsource that particular how the question paper is being made. So there are some people, they are supposed to formulate the question paper, and there is a possibility that different examination may have similar questions, or you can say same questions. So why not, when you are preparing for any examination in 2022, so at least 2022 and 2021, you cover up whatever similar examinations you have in the previous time. Those questions papers also you can practice. That will give you much confidence for the examination. And obviously, the YouTube sessions on the Baiju's Exam Prep English YouTube channel, they are going to help you a lot in the right direction for this examination. Let me just show you the exact schedule that we are going to follow. Today is 4th of July, Monday. Faneen sir and myself, we are talking about the syllabus, the important topics, and study and practice material. Now, 6th of July, that is Wednesday, day after tomorrow, your favorite and our favorite, Dinesh Gutha sir is going to start with signal and system. And he is going to talk about the classification of systems and convolution. What is the timing of this class? The timing of the class is going to be 5 p.m. in the evening. So if you want, you can take a snapshot. Is it clear? If you want, you can take a snapshot. I'm just giving you the full screen. You can just take the snapshot. Again, I'm telling you, day after tomorrow, 6th of July, Wednesday, your favorite and my favorite, Dinesh Gutha sir is going to start signal and system, and he's going to talk about the classification of systems and convolution, 5 p.m. in the evening, only on Baiju's Exam Prep. Is it clear, everybody? Just tell me in the comment section. Can I deserve a like, and can I deserve a response from your side? Are you able to follow me and Faneen sir, what we are trying to tell you? Yes, everyone. Are you having the same excitement for this examination? Just tell me in the comment section. And if you have any more questions, I would request Faneen sir to please join me and answer any questions from your side. Yes, everyone. Any more questions you have, you can tell me in the comment section. Thank you so much, Chandrasekhar, for showing this much love and appreciation. So guys, any more questions you want? One more thing I want to say, if you have any more questions, once this session is closed, when this session is off, you can put your questions in the comment section of this video. Me and Faneen sir will try our level best, and we are going to be more than happy to answer and address any of your doubts. Next thing what you can do is, you can join my personal Telegram channel on Baiju's Exam Prep, or Faneen sir's personal Telegram channel on Baiju's Exam Prep. And you can raise n number of technical, non-technical, whatever questions you want for your career. Yes, sir.
Yes. Some of the students are asking the question like, you want the model test. Yes, we have planned it. We have planned the model test. But what we have understood is there are so many students who have not done the GATE preparation. So unless until we have given the proper guidance to them as well as proper classes to them, then only they will be able to write the model test, right? But surely, once we complete all the sessions on the technical topics, like how Dinesh Gutha sir is going to handle the signals and systems from the Wednesday 5 p.m. onwards, followed to Dinesh Gutha sir, we are having the classes by Sanjay Rathi sir, India's famous faculty on circuit theory. Then either me or Rakesh sir will going to handle. After that, we will also have the core subjects discussion also. Once we have completed all these things, parallelly we can start writing the model test also, because we have extensively planned for the model test along with the material and the previous questions of HPCL. Okay, so that's why again and again we are saying that those who are not finding the resources anywhere for HPCL, because even myself I have gone through here and there and understood that there is no proper guidance, especially for HPCL. We have taken this much amount of time to have a proper background planning and foundation, and we are clear with our plan. So the only thing, it is ball is in your court. Now it is you, how hard you are going to hit it. Okay. So now moving ahead to very important thing, as I was saying earlier. So the Telegram group, either you can join with the Telegram group of Ashutosh sir or me to see the regular updates, along with that, the regular support also. Okay. So the last but not least, if you want to have a solid preparation for ESC as well as GATE, Byju's exam prep is going to be one of the best solution and single solution for that. So this is a great session. I hope you really loved it and enjoyed it. And if you got something out of this session, so please mention that in the comment box. And we are very eager to hear from your side. Almost every question we have answered with a great patience, and we are able to answer the questions even that are coming in the upcoming days also. So it's up to you how well you are going to utilize the sessions from the Wednesday 5 p.m. onwards. We are starting with the common subject, that is signals and system, by India's most renowned faculty, Dinesh Gupta sir. And I'm very sure that you will enjoy his class. Even I am very eager to see Dinesh sir class on signals and systems, and follow to that circuit theory classes. Every session what is coming on here is very well articulated and very well planned, and it is extremely useful for majority of the students in a most conventional way. So hope you guys really enjoy by watching the lecture series, and it will be useful to you. And as I was saying here and again, along with that, definitely we'll go and give so many model tests, and even the students who have cleared the stage one and stage two, even we will be planning to give personal interview sessions also. So hope in all dimensions, our support will be there, and our support was there, our support is there, and our support will be there in the future also. Thank you very much to every one of you.
That's a great information coming from our legendary sir, Faneen sir. Sir, one opportunity I want to ask from you, because I have seen some of the comments that students are saying we have not prepared for GATE, or they are not sure about this particular recruitment. Let me tell you a few lines that it is in Hindi. I'm sorry for that, because I cannot translate it into English. That manzile dil ke irade aazmati hain. If you fail somewhere, don't worry. It's just one new opportunity for you. मंजिलें दिल के इरादे आजमाती हैं, स्वप्न के पर्दे आंखों से गिराती हैं. मंजिलें दिल के इरादे आजमाती हैं, स्वप्न के पर्दे आंखों से गिराती हैं. हौसला मत हार गिरकर ओ मुसाफिर, ठोकरे इंसान को चलना सिखाती हैं. सो यू कीप ऑन गोइंग, दैट इज द ओनली वे आउट टू गेट अ सक्सेसफुल कैरियर आउट ऑफ दीज रिक्रूटमेंट प्रोसेसेस. सो थैंक यू सो मच वंस अगेन, एंड थैंक यू सो मच फनीन सर फॉर दिस great discussion, and allowing me to be a part of this with you to enrich our students for HPCL recruitment. And guys, be ready for the music, be ready for the light, camera and action on 6th of July, 5 p.m. in the evening. Byju's exam prep is coming up with the final solution for HPCL recruitment for electrical and instrumentation. Thank you so much, sir.
Ashutosh sir, before closing the session, let me take 1 minute. There was one student who is asking the question. He was not prepared the GATE examination. Yes, very good. Santosh, in your case, I want you to think in this way. Suppose if you have extensively prepared for the GATE examination, then each and every topic again and again, you will study so deeply. When the exam standard is not so big, when the exam standard is not so difficult, then it will be really helpful for the students who have not done the GATE preparation. This is the reason why we are saying that, as we know your requirement, as we know your demands, as we know your level of examination preparation, we have designed a comprehensive model specially separately for HPCL, and that will be launching from the Wednesday 5 p.m. onwards. And Dinesh Gupta sir will going to help you in signals and system, and followed by that we will going to take all other technical subjects. Hope everything will going to help you in a most genuine way and conventional way, and try to utilize the resources as maximum as possible, and all these sessions are free of cost, and explore as much as you can. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.